And so we sang that song going down the escalator. What you just heard is what they heard. They heard that in the bar. Alright, now, let me bring it down here a second. I want a final message here to this amazing collection of souls here on Sunday afternoon. After we rotted the Trump Tower, we went to the cheapest restaurant we could find at 5th Avenue, 58th Street. The Bengal Tiger at 56th. Just to tip you off. Tables are made of formica. It started occurring to us what had happened there. We sing and preach straight into the air quite easily, partly because, first of all, when you're handling large volumes of sound, your body wants to do that. You want to have an open chest and your arms out and your chin up. But also, we've given full concerts for tree sitters on the border of California and Oregon up there. And then we've done this before. Calling out to the honeybees, we were doing it again. Going to the natural world when we had a crisis set some things in motion. And I just want to urge you to consider in your activism that when you're stuck, when you're cornered by the police, whatever form it takes, go to the natural world. Earth Alleluia, just say, talk to me, talk to me, tell me what to do. We don't know why we called out to the honeybees. Bless so many beekeepers, and we've been fighting Monsanto for so long, you know. But of course, it's one of our issues. But going to the earth, going to the sky, that changed the entire event, because the police believed that we were calling out to the lost Dauphine up there, Baron Trump, in his window. And they believed that our loud music was ricocheting up this glorified air shaft on 5th Avenue, and it was reaching Queen Melania herself. And they were getting worried, and they were getting worried that this just wasn't working out. Get these protesters off this little ledge on the side of this 750-foot monstrosity. So we realized that it wasn't just a case of possible embarrassment to the first family. It wasn't just a case of these people being talked to in a rough way by their superiors, that they let some crazy people shout loud enough to reach up there. Really, what was going on was there was the going to the honeybees activated very old mythologies in us, in all of us. And the couple hundred people out on that little ledge, all of us in the choir as well. How isn't the most basic origin source story of the Western canon? Isn't it the prodigal son story? Are we hoping that Baron Trump escapes from his trap up there? He'll run away with the circus. It might not be us, but he'll run away with some circus, won't he? Amen. And we will cheer for him. And so many of the stories, from Jesus Christ to Mr. Darcy and Pride and Prejudice to Luke Skywalker and Star Wars, it's just on and on and on. We're just replicating the story of the son who escapes and comes back and changes his father. And the trophy queen trapped in the tower of the castle. That's so, Jane Eyre. You can just recite the old stories in our lives that are part of our genetic makeup that we may have activated there. Go to the airport and I'll admit that I do this at this time. Go to the bodice ripping section of the Hudson bookstore, and there's always a picture of a castle, and there's a little light on at the top. Amen. Somebody's up there. Some kinky 700-year-old secret is up in that tower, and it's embodied in a woman who's trapped there. The prodigal son, the trapped queen. They are narratives that are radical. Just because they've been co-opted by Hollywood and commodified doesn't mean that we can use them too.
That's right.
We did that day, we used them, we realized we got into Hollywood that day and stole something and got away. And we had a radical message. It went into our First Amendment. Do you believe in micro gestures? We only reached a few hundred people that day, but it meant something, and we were carrying the power of that story. Amen. When we made the deal that all the mythologies would be destroyed, all the goddesses, when we said, oh, we're gonna set out across the desert and make a deal with this militaristic god, and that deal is that he's the only god, and we're gonna wipe out all the earth culture. We're going to call that the wilderness, and we're going to subjugate that. And we're going to follow this fossil fuel pillar of fire across the desert to the promised land, and we will slaughter those people. We'll bring our slaves with us. When we made that deal, we distorted our mythologies. We gave to the prodigal son. We gave to the trapped queen in the tower. A sort of sadomasochistic kind of theory. But they have to be free. They are the stories that oppose the patriarch. They are the stories that will make us go to the wilderness and befriend it and defend it. And ask the wilderness to defend us. And they will get us out of the chosen people promised land. Fetish. It's sick. It's deadly. It's genocide. Stop it. We will all be the prodigal son. And we will all be the feminine who escapes out of the castle. And we will oppose the patriarch. And we will defeat Donald Trump.